Good evening. I'm Kill the Vid, your host for the 9-to-5 Outlaw, Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. And I'm back again with another edition of Let's Play Classic featuring Assassin's Creed Syndicate. This is going to be gaming livestream walkthrough episode 5, focused on the DLC called Dreadful Crimes, where Jacob and Evie are solving some unsolved cases and helping out an author and his lad to write petty dreadfuls of actual crimes. But they are the ones, Jacob and Evie are the ones doing the dirty work in this case. They're the ones solving the crimes while Henry Raymond, that's the author's name, writes about them. So it's kind of a mutual relationship and beneficial relationship. So I've solved a lot of them, but however, certain cases I've made the wrong accusations, and as a result the reward money went down. So I'm going to continue on with that. So if you haven't done so already, like, follow, subscribe to the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel, and hit the notifications so whenever I go live, you'll be the first to know. But grab a snack, grab a drink, grab what you need. It's time for Let's Play Classic featuring Assassin's Creed Syndicate, right now on the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. Here we go. See if I can get a visual. Right, we've got visual. So let's move on with the next series of dreadful crimes. I don't know how many there are, but I'd like to get through them so that I can go on with the episodic DLC, which of course are Jack the Ripper and Last Maharaja. So you can see Jacob Frye is in his sportsman, outdoorsy detective outfit, you know, which he resembles Sherlock Holmes. moved on to the next dreadful crime. This one is called Conjuring Up a Killing, which I gather is the murder of a magician, I guess. So let's fast travel there. Much as I like to explore the city, I like to do fast travel and get there, get to the district very quickly. So I'm back in Westminster, which is the more upscale district in London. Shouldn't you be at
home? Back to your post.
I run like a dairy farmer, cause you fight like a cow.
You've done it now, boy.
Oh boy. Oh, you want some of this?
You think it's doing me? At last, I found you!
This is where you'll find a game champion in!
Yeah, yeah!
Bye-bye. Shut the hell up. Why would you shut the hell up?
Dead as a drowned rat.
They must be under a lot of pressure. They've got their work cut out for them.
Let me see. I want to see.
So this looks like this is Charles Dickens. Solve the murder of spiritualist Thaddeus the Amazing. Potential rewards, 2,500 pounds and 1,000 XP.
My dear friend, the Ghost Club has an extraordinary case for you. Spiritualist Thaddeus the Amazing has predicted his own death at his next seance. Could you have a look?
Reach the seance. Be right back.
down, you silly nag.
Keep moving.
Let's go.
Easy, girl. Easy. See?
Walk on, girl. That's the way. That's a girl.
Which way to the seance?
Steady on. Who's a good horse? You are. That's the way.
Moving.
Might have to double back.
He's up there.
Yeah.
Doing fine, good.
Easy does it.
Walk on, girl. All together now. Let's go. Steady on.
Come on, you silly man.
That's a girl.
Count on me, Jacob, if you need me.
Thank you. believe that shall help you greatly.
Someone's kicked a rocket.
This brute's met a nasty...
You're looking so tough now, are you?
So, looking at two cases, two remaining cases. Or I'm gonna probably skip this and do this and then come back to it, maybe. I guess I'll do that. Bring in the action.
Buried. No one soon you. The grave.
Or I could restart it. Start the memory. Because I'm kind of lost.
Thank you.
My dear friend, the Ghost Club has an extraordinary case for you. Spiritualist Thaddeus the Amazing has predicted his own death at his next seance. Could you have a look?
I guess I'll follow him.
Spare a coin for the poor of London. Your charity is my survival.
try different things.
My dear friend, the Ghost Club has an extraordinary case for you. Spiritualist Thaddeus the Amazing has predicted his own death at his next seance. Could you have a look?
Please don't. Please, I'm
making a request now.
Oh, God!
This can all aim for.
My word. My word.
Please, no.
I can't begin to. I express my gratitude.
I'm gonna try to go to the quick screen. Guess we'll do this. The darkest hour, 3,532 pounds and 4,000 XP.
future, follow Lydia Frye. She will lead you to me.
This is probably taking place in 1914. This must be a Frye ancestor. What's a generator?
Position of the second wave.
1 hour away, at most.
Oh. The generator support. Generators are connected to electrical devices. Disabling generators shut down any device they are attached to, causing people to come and investigate.
I'm worried about you. I fear there may be spiders living behind your eyeballs. But I'd like to have a look for myself, just to be on the safe side. You can never be too careful. Make mad the guilty and the poor the free. Confound the ignorant.
Okay.
Escape! Stop right there!
That's not very polite.
Even in these trying times, we must never forget the laws of common courtesy. Arms down.
Must be, Yep, Sir Winston Churchill.
We appear to have been following the same trail, Miss Frye.
I got here first.
Indeed, you are to be commended. I fear, however, that we have not wholly rooted out the evil in this vicinity.
There's another radio.
Accompany me, if you would be so kind.
German.
That second device must be found, or new waves of Zeppelins will soon blanket the heavens.
Short on soldiers, are we?
If you could put your considerable talents to good use at Tower Bridge, you would have the thanks of a brave but beleaguered nation.
So this is Sir Winston Churchill in his younger days. The darkest hour.
We have word of further spires near Tower Bridge. If you can locate them, I have no doubt they'll have information on that second radio. Wherever these people are, trouble is sure to follow. Someone of your talents should have little difficulty in identifying them.
Find info about the radio. Steal info about them. London, 1916. Boy, it's a long way down. So there's a little break in the action, folks. I decided to do The Darkest Hour. Looks like a mini episode. Not sure how long it is, but it takes place in 1916 during the last 2 years of World War I, where the British are also part of the Allied forces fighting against Nazi Germany. So this is Lydia Frye, who is the descendant of Jacob and Amy. So we're jumping from 1868 to 1916. So if you think about it, it's about, probably about 18 to 28 years into the future. I would say probably 20 years. Let's see here. 1868. Or maybe it's, ...48 years into the future. Almost 50 years. Oh, shit. So first, we're gonna find information about the ring.
Huh?
tanks. Wonder if I get to ride any of them. Instead of horse and buggy, looking at tanks.
This is just dandy.
We have work to do.
They go and close the bloody bridge.
Why don't we just move the vehicles out of the way? This new captain's got some funny ideas.
Of a radio? Where is it?
like the look of those new chaps. They'll are anyone these days.
The radio's close to the river, but I need more than this.
Seen before. Untie me right now. That's my boat.
Let's go.
You know what to do.
Thank you.
Whatever. The radio's in the bridge itself, North Tower. I should drop by and say hello.
Thank you.
psychological warfare.
I know what we've been told, but this still don't sit right with me. London burning by our own. You've got to look at the bigger picture. Even now, are you?
Take that, you traitors.
It is done, sir.
Let us postpone celebrations while the bloody blimps has broken through. Don't worry. I have a contingency plan.
The Zeppelin attack. reach the anti-aircraft gun. Boom, motherfucker. Find a way for playing. Thank you.
heartwarming sight, Miss Frye.
Your remarkably armed boat deserves a share of recognition.
One of my experimental projects when I was Lord of the Admiralty. I haven't always been a man of shadows.
And I suppose this victory will thrust you back into the limelight.
We may have struck a blow against the enemy, but London is still riddled with German agents. Currently, there's a new group, unlike anything I've seen before. Theirs is a fanatical, almost religious fervor.
And you believe I'm the woman to flush them out?
Indeed. I dare not approach Mr. Asquith without firmer evidence, but I believe they pose an immediate threat. If you concede to this, I give you my word that once I've battled my way back into Parliament, I shall see if something can't be done about your request. As you're aware, a vote can be far more lethal than a bullet or a blade.
Okay. I met the objectives, the challenge. So I'm looking at 3,532 plus 150 pounds. 4,000 XP, and I get a military suit as an outfit. Okay. Don't know what the hell that was about. I'm gonna need to stack up. Here's the next portal to 1868. Yes, I think I'll stay here. Spy hunts, spy hideout, master spy. Hideout. April 1915. Dear Uncle, I'm recovering quite well from my wounds, so the doctor tells me. There is still such a thick air of dejection in the hospital. And we all remember the friends we've lost in what a futile effort we lost them. The scenes of Dardanelles will haunt us for many years, I expect, though I was pleased to hear your news from home. Churchill deserves much worse than to be cast out of the Admiralty for the mess he brought us into at Gallipoli. If, as you say, he is making plans to see the Western Front for himself, then no doubt his recklessness will bring him graver punishment. I look forward to sailing home once I am sufficiently well, and appreciate your offer of a post in Westminster. I intend to do you proud and to endeavor to win this war from the officers of London, since I could accomplish so little here. Your faithful nephew, George. Lieutenant George Featherway had a short career as a politician and prospered as a businessman after the war. What's next? Winston. Let's go on with the next mission. So we gotta dismantle the spy networks. Because I no longer have the carriage privilege, so let's see what I can find. I guess we'll report to Mr. Winston Churchill.
Come right over there and deal with you myself.
You'll do no such thing. Run your shit.
Come
Calm down. No use leaving the body here. Off you go. And you? Use a topping on. Going to the castle.
Oh, I'm so scared. Come on over here.
Take that, fucker. Now for silent but deadly.
mercy on my soul!
Bye-bye. This is the last hour of the stream. Booyah!
I never saw her.
Yeah, works for me.
Is she all right, do you reckon? I mean in the head.
Yeah. Now mind your business. Piss off.
Suddenly this no longer seems like an enjoyable spot.
Yeah, be gone. Mind your business, okay? And I'll mind mine. Unless you want to get thrown, get out of here. Beat it. Scram. Get the stepping. Make yourself scarce. Those are nosy ass fucking people. Watch out.
Help me. I'm going back home.
Yeah, go back home. Got some concert you gotta get to or something? Or some auction? Get out of here. Split. Scram. Fuck off. Get. Be gone. I'm just gonna turn shit off around here. How you like that? Turn off the generator. I guess they were coal powered or whatever they used, the fuel source, maybe early petrol.
think they'd get Jorm killed.
Let nature take its course. In other words, let them kill each other.
The little piggy has no fashion sense and needs to die.
Shut the fuck up. How you like that? You won't need it where you're going. To see the old boy.
Do you read me? Good. The drop-off will occur at the coordinates specified.
Okay, here's the merchant. This is the base of operation.
You won't find better.
Eagle to rest.
Have a good day now.
Let's go speak with the chapel.
Do you read me? Hello, hello.
I hope you like my new office, Miss Frye. As you can see, my informants have found some promising leads. Evidence of spy activity has surfaced around the Field Hospital, St. Catherine's Docks, and the Tower of London. I needn't remind you how crucial it is that we put a stop to these infiltrators.
You got it, old boy. Now we're talking. Spy hunt. The apocryphy. Apothecary. Apothecary. Twins. Hopton's. 17 Walpole Lane. Spy hunt. The Magpie. Clarence Stockhouse. Only paying 400, 500 pounds. Start with. Divide and conquer. Thank you. take that, fucker. Now, how about a little psychological warfare? Grab one of the bodies.
Make sure she can't walk away. There you are.
Ooh. Sucker. Got a body for you. Drop.
If I come over there, I'll introduce you to my baton.
I'm going to come over there and fuck you up.
Thank you. that woman there. I'm gonna knock it.
See this.
Jason Bear!
Last half hour of this. What was that?
Boom, motherfucker.
Stop. I'll stop you myself.
I once loathed the very sight of your kind, in the same way you recoil in the presence of an arachnid. Humans were created by we who came before, the Isu. We crafted you in our image, but deprived you of our true gifts. You were bred for hard labor, and in extreme cases, war. We built great observatories to monitor you, devices to control you. We blessed you with resilience, but cursed you with ambition. And so you rebelled against us. I suppose we are to blame for the state of your species. Is it any wonder so many of these simulations revolve around violence?
Thank you.
So that's taken care of.
Thank you.
last 18 minutes of the stream.
Good on you. This one.
That's 10 minutes of the screen.
Yeah, good on ya.
Stop.
Come again now.
Do you read me? Good. The drop off will occur.
Survive on the streets. Look no further. Get your everyday attention.
Can you hear me?
Just
please,
come talk to me.
Cone.
Everything.
Looks like that's going to do it for this edition of Let's Play Classic between Assassin's Creed Syndicate on the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTuber Twitch channel. Until then, I'm Kill the Vid. And please,